Hello, this is Darwok, and this is coming to you very late as round 6 of the Toyota GR Cup is happening this weekend, and I have yet to upload rounds 4 or 5, so I'm doing a 2-for-1 in this video. I'm cutting out the practice session because, let's face it, it's not that interesting, and I'm smashing both of them together. So this is qualifying for round 4. I'm going to skip the outlap here too because I got to try and fit everything in here. The thing about this race was car choice. The fastest option was the GR Supra. However, I found that to be really oversteery and I often lost it coming out of corners, so I opted to use the Mazda instead, which was slower but more stable. And I was pretty much the only person running this car in the race. I'll just let the race speak for itself. It happened a long time ago now, so I don't really remember the details. I don't think there was any major drama in this one. But here we go with qualifying. So there we go, 6th place for qualifying. Nothing spectacular, just average performance for me. Let's get on to the race. I'm gonna have to cut most of the car parade here, but I always spend the time to make a new livery for a race, and this is the only time you get to see it, so I will keep this running just until my own car shows up, then I'll skip it. I went for a 2000 AD theme this time, just because I had the decals available. I haven't used them yet, so there we go, Judge Dredd car. Okay, here we go. Thank you. So we recovered from all the carnage at the start and managed to get back up to sixth position where we began. All the numbers went up, driver rating went up, so I was content with that. Nothing spectacular, but a solid finish, and I should get more points in the next race because my DR has gone up. Okay, so we're on to round 5, and this is a much trickier proposition because I suck in the Super Formula cars. I also had another misconception regarding strategy because I thought it was a 30-lap race. I'd practiced with the wrong group. I practiced with some GT1 drivers who do have to run 30 laps. I only have to run 20 in GT2. I didn't notice this, and so what I did was I tried to run most of the race on mediums so that I could keep the softs going at the end. I could have actually done most of the race on softs instead of mediums, so that was a huge mistake and probably cost me. Anyway, this is qualifying, and yeah, this is not pretty either, so let's see what happens. We're on the outlap, and I'm about to get a run on this guy with a view to getting ahead of him before the hot laps, but he starts weaving all over the place here. So I'm now considering him a dangerous competitor, and I'm very nervous about having close to me on the hot laps. As we go into them, ahead, but wary of dive bombs from behind. Not sure if it's because I'm distracted by the guy behind me, but I ended up running just a little bit too wide here, went off the track and invalidated both laps in one fell swoop. So not going to set a qualifying time, not a valid one anyway. I will be starting from the back. As it turned out, my best lap in free practice would have put me 8th on this grid, so I couldn't have expected any better than that anyway. Yeah, just unfortunate that qualifying was a write-off, but I kept running to get the practice in. It's all getting a bit chaotic. I don't know if I'm to blame for that or not. I'll let you guys be the judge. I wasn't trying to hit anyone. I also noticed that this guy in front of me, Toya, is he was in the last race too, so I'm starting to see the same competitors coming back. Alright, so disastrous qualifying. Let's have a look at the starting grid. just to reiterate my strategy confusion, I was aware that I could run about 18 laps, no problem, on the soft tires. But I thought that this was a 30 lap race. So I started on mediums with the intention of taking them to like lap 15 or so, just so that I would have healthier soft tires at the end of the race. And I was thinking this the whole time, completely unaware that it is a 20 lap race. So that's gonna be the main problem here. I'm gonna run to lap 15 on the slower tire. Whereas other people are starting on softs or doing one lap of mediums and switching to softs and taking them as far as they can. So I'm using a late 90s Stuart Ford inspired livery for this. Unfortunately, I didn't quite wrap the blue decal all the way around the, the halo there. So there's a little white part, apologies for that. Here we go, let's see what I can do. This is kind of what I was hoping for, people making mistakes, getting penalties, running off track. That's how I'm more likely to make up positions, because I do not have the fast pace in this car. the guy that I passed because of his penalty quite easily took the position back there. More likely he's on soft tires compared to me on the mediums, still thinking that I had the right strategy when I had the wrong strategy. So yeah, a lot of these people are on the faster tire. That was very clumsy. I don't know if that was legit or not. I did not get a penalty. I probably should have. A bit forceful. And I just saw in the rear view mirror that he got punted again by the guy behind me, so he's dropped two positions in a rather unfair fashion. Somebody else off the track, so that's another position gained. My thinking at this point was I'm gonna like stay on the mediums until I feel like I'm like really being pressured or harassed from behind, and then that will be the point that I switch to the soft. So I was even like trying to push it longer than I comfortably wanted to, still thinking that it's a 30 lap race. Thank you. So my 7th position just turned to 6th, so somebody has gone into the pits. Now running in 6th, the guy in front is occasionally getting closer, and the guys behind are not really pushing me too much, so it's actually looking not too bad at this point. So I'm going to give a little bit of future insight here. I looked at the replay afterwards, and it turned out that at this stage of the race, my Warn mediums were running at a kind of similar pace to the fastest guy's Warn soft. So I was actually in a good position here and didn't realize it. And running on the mediums was actually doing me a favor. starting to think about making my pit stop now, but I'm working on the philosophy that if it isn't broken, don't fix it, because I have no visibility of other people's pace or anything in VR. I'm just going by how it feels, if I'm gaining or if I'm being pressured. So far so good, so I decided to stay out for the time being. So the sight of the 7-Up livery Jordan there and the rough last corner prompted the decision to pit now, because it was starting to get a little bit unwieldy. So we're going to switch over to softs, and theoretically I should be faster when I come out. So we exit the pits in 11th position, and this was quite demoralizing. But of course, there's the strategy thing, and a lot of people started on softs and are going to switch to mediums in the very last lap, so there is still a chance that I'll make up some positions at the end. Of course, I'm still thinking it's a 30 lap race. Thank you. passing two cars in the pits and one on the track to get back up to seventh, one position away from where I was before the pit stop. So with any luck, I can get that back before the end of the race. This is what I was hoping for, somebody pitting on the very last lap to change to the mediums. And it was flicking up and down for a bit there, but we did get sixth position. So this is also the point that I noticed it's only a 20 lap race when I saw the final lap warning up there. So now I knew I just had to keep this position for one more lap. Another sixth position, and I felt quite lucky to get this one given my strategy mistake, which turned out to be not so much of a mistake, and also the fact that I'm not good in the Super Formula cars. I do love racing in VR, but one of the drawbacks of it is you don't get the big picture of the race. You can't see other drivers' pace or positions or anything like that. So after looking at the replay, it seemed like a lot of the faster people over one lap were not as good at keeping on the track, so a lot of them had to like fight back to get their positions again. Also the fact that the mediums and softs at the same stage of their life were pretty much comparable in pace, as far as I could tell, helped me a lot. It is annoying to get a sixth so many times because the game credits you for getting the top five but not in the top six. However, it's my best points haul so far, and it's put my provisional cash rewards up by a fair chunk, so hopefully I can keep that going for the next one. Next one is the GR Yaris at Grand Valley South, and that is happening this weekend. I've been trying to practice it, haven't done a lobby race yet, so I'm not sure on strategy. Hopefully after that race it won't take me quite as long to get it uploaded, but thank you for watching. There'll be other games coming soon. I'm on a bit of a weird summer schedule because of the kids being off school and everything, but I'll be back soon. Thank you for watching. See you.